Yesterday, we have seen what is enlightenment and what is liberation. To understand that we have no work psychologically is known as enlightenment. When we understand there is no work psychologically on our part, we leave the mind on its own. When we leave the mind on its own, the mind gets liberated. So that is the liberation. So for that, we have to understand we have no work psychologically. But does not mean physical work. So the psychological work alone it means. Psychologically, we have no work. But we are facing many problems in our life. We have to be answerable for many circumstances. Many things we have to be answerable. And we have to respond. For that, we should not keep ourselves without any work. So we have to work. Externally, we have to work. Internally and psychologically, we have no work. For that, we have referred an example yesterday. We have a due that we have to pay $10,000 yesterday morning within 10 o'clock. We have to settle. If you do not settle the amount in the due time, we have to face so many complications. So thereby, we are restless. We are unable to pay the amount. So when we do not pay the, when we do not able to pay the amount, we are restless. And get away from the restlessness, we take liquor. By taking liquor or sleeping tablets, thereby we should not solve the problem of settling the amount. But we are giving some settlement to the mind. We give some comfort to the mind. So here, the psychological part is one thing, and the physical work is another thing. Actually, the physical work may be the reason, the physical issue may be the reason for our psychological stress. But we have to deal with the psychological aspect and we have to deal with the physical aspect also. The psychological aspect and physical aspect are interconnected. When one is affected, the other one is also affected. So we have to deal with the psychological problem as well as the physical problem. So what to do with the physical problem and what to do with the psychological problem? We all know taking liquor and sleeping tablets is not the solution, is not the way to deal with the psychological problem. And some other selected the sophisticated way of doing some meditation or other things to console their psychological structure. But that is, it is also kind of escape. But actually, the liberated mind solves the psychological problem also. If you are liberated, if your mind is liberated, it will saturate itself. Just like a living river, just like a living moving river, it will wash away all the dust. Just like that, our liberated mind will look after itself without any problem psychologically. But it will not create, it will not solve the physical problem. Physical problem is somewhat different. But psychologically, the function of the mind is somewhat different. But the solution to the psychological problem and solution to the physical problem is also somewhat different. But in the psychological problem is concerned, we have no work. We have to leave the mind at all. But physical problem, we have to take everything in our hand. We have to do the possible work there. But psychological work is concerned, we have to accept our total failure. Whatever work you have to do, it is a struggle within yourself. So psychologically, as early as possible, we have to fail with the psychological work. We have to fail in the psychological work. We should not correct ourselves psychologically. We should not set right ourselves psychologically. We have to leave it as it is, unattended. But success is the goal in the external world, in the physical world. In the physical thing, success alone is the goal. Success alone is the end. In the psychological world is concerned, failure alone is the goal. Failure alone is the end. So we have to leave the mind as it is. Then only some different kind of connection will happen between the psychological thing and the physical world. Psychological mind and the physical issues. For example, I put my hand here, and upon my hand I put down a suitcase weighting 50 kilograms or more. What will happen? It will crush my fingers. It has no power to sustain the weight of the 50 kilograms or more. I have no power, the hand has no power. But at the same time, when I want to take my suitcase with the weight of 50 kilogram, the strength will come. If I want to lift my suitcase, some weight, some power will come to my hand and we can lift. But after lifting the suitcase, the power will go away from the hand. So in this way, if we put our psychological structure naturally, some other different kind of strength will come to set right the situation also, set right the physical problem also. So that is the unconsciously, we have some connection. Our psychological structure and the physical work, we have some unconscious connection. And the psychological structure will look after itself. More than that, it will look after the external world also. It will helpful to the external world. First of all, we have to understand, we have to reject the psychological mind totally. That we have to understand and find out the goodness, find out the correctness, that we have no work psychologically. Once I had an instance, one girl, maybe around 20 or 25. She might have gone through some of my books or videos, I don't know. One day she phoned me. Now I am in a stress. I have a love affair with one boy. We decided to marry. But unfortunately, he refused my companion and selected one another girl and married with her. Now I am unable to bear with the loss, bear with the situation. So I am terribly confused, terribly in a worry. So I cannot sleep, I cannot eat. I am in a boiling condition. What we have to do? So here, what is the answer? So I told her, so whoever in your position, the same reaction will come. That is natural. They will not be happy. So you have been cheated by somebody. So you have to face the situation. So whoever in the situation, their condition of the mind will be like this. So you have to accept the response, accept the loss, accept the sorrow of your mind wholeheartedly. That is your case. Sometimes you have some work in the external world to do some legal work, you may proceed. But psychologically, you need not proceed with your worry. You need not proceed with your sorrow. So psychologically, you have to accept your sorrow wholeheartedly. But here, they have no marital connection, marital relationship with the boy, she has no legal right also. The boy can get married with anybody on his choice. But if he already married with this lady, he has a legal right to sue with the other person. But here, externally, no work. But psychologically, we feel sorrow. So I asked her, you accept the sorrow wholeheartedly. But if we think, it is a good advice for her. She was in sorrow. She wants some remedy from me. And I simply told her, accept your sorrow. Is it a remedy? But I have said like that, and she also accepted like that. Next day morning, she also phoned again. But thought, so the yesterday consolement is not good, it's not, it may not be working, she want more consolation, more counseling. So I asked, what's the matter? Then she told, when I got up from my bed, today I am very terribly glad, I feel very blissful in my mind. I don't know why the bliss consciousness came to me. I am very happy. I don't know why this bliss consciousness came to me. I am able to understand because the situation is not good. The situation has not changed. But psychologically, I feel very happy. I feel very blissful. I don't know why this bliss consciousness came to me. She asked me. So whenever we are struggling with something, some dissipation of energy is there. When we are not struggling with ourselves, the dissipation of energy stops. So the mind has to function in a different way. So that is the thing. So when we take any burden with ourselves, any weight with ourselves, when we put down the weight, we feel the loss of weight. So in this way, the mind has changed the pattern of working. So it may have chance, there may be a chance. This is a living example. That is why she got the blissful experience. So psychologically, we have no work. We have to understand first. psychologically. Otherwise, if you do not understand, naturally the natural tendency is to saturate our psychological structure, saturate our psychological emotions. That is why you are going towards the liquor bottle or sleeping tablets or any other drugs. But we have to understand, psychologically we have no work. But all work is related to the physical things. Physical world, we have to work. We have to plan. But whenever you take the work and when you neglect the psychological world, the physical world alone is real. But in the religious world, there may be some sayings that the entire world is unreal, the entire world is false, the spiritual world alone is real, we have to give weight to the spiritual world, we should neglect the physical world, we should neglect our family, we have to neglect our people, we neglect our property, we have to give importance to the spiritual thing alone. But in reality, the physical world alone is real. The spiritual world alone is unreal. Actually, there is no spiritual world. We have to leave it as it is. But we have to take the real world, the physical world alone in our hand. We have some work in the physical world alone, but we have no work in the psychological world. But we have to understand. Unless we understand that there is no work in the psychological world, we will not leave it. Before leaving it, we have to understand there is no work in the psychological world. There is no work in the spiritual world. Then only it is real spiritual world. Then only it is a real spiritual work. So doing some practice, only for the beginners, you may do some practice, meditation, japa, dhyana, going prayers, many things we can do for the as a beginner, we can do something. But afterwards, when we understand this thing, we have to put down everything. Psychologically, there is no work on our part. So in the physical world alone, we have to take the physical world alone in our hand. Then only some different perception will have taken even in the spiritual world itself. There are many people, they may be a businessman or anybody, but after understanding this, they got many progress in their physical work, in their business world. Because they are able to understand the real nature, real complications in a different perception. Because when there is no work on our psychological part, the total energy turns towards the external world and do wonders there also. For example, you are traveling for a long distance and you are going to meet your friend who is living alone in a village, and you travel a lot and you are very tired on reaching the house of your friend. When you reach the house of your friend is locking the door outside. On seeing you coming there, he opened the door once again and you asked to take rest here because you are going very late, around 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock in the night, and you are very tired and you want to take some rest. And your friend also telling you that you take rest and I have some urgent work outside and I am going there. And after finishing the work, I'll return. He said like that. And we accept that I am taking rest in the house and you go the outside. But I am very tired. I cannot, when you return, I cannot open my door. So you simply lock the door outside and you go. Whenever you return, you yourself can open the door and come inside. And your friend has locked the door outside and gone away. And you enter into the house and reach the bedroom and put on the light. And somebody is waiting for you. And in the bedroom, a big cobra is standing with a hood. What will you do? If the door is not locked outside, everybody is doing, will do the only one thing alone. we can meet our friend there next time. Now we can escape from the house. That will do. But we cannot go away. We have to face the snake. First time alone, you see the snake in one cinema alone. In film alone, you saw the snake like this. Now you face the real snake in front of you. We have to face the snake. And you keep still and you watch the snake and the snake watches you. And time passes. Then only you came to understand, as you are afraid of the snake is also afraid of you. And in course of time, the snake goes away the house as it comes within the house. So here, looking to escape from the situation is dealing with the psychological structure. Dealing with the psychological structure, psychological emotions, is just like escaping from the situation. But whenever we locked, there is no place to run away from the situation, we simply accept the psychological factor. And your choice is only the external situation. Whenever you are faced with an exceptional situation, idea, different kind of approach will happen to you. If you simply accept, if you simply escape, so you cannot deal with the external situation. So here, the first of all, we have to reject the psychological world, psychological structure. And the psychological structure will help you to deal with the situation in a different perception, different way. And I had, when I was a boy, as a school-going boy, I had an experience. One day I prepared to go to school. My house was in a village like this. And I have to walk up to the school for around 1 kilometer. And my house was situated within a garden, some spacious garden. And we have bred a dog also. It was a wandering dog within our compound, within our premises. We have not tied it. So when I go to the school, the dog is also trying to accompany me, with me. But I try to force it to remain in the house. It is not accepted my word, and he simply followed me. Why I was afraid is that On the way to the school, there are some streets where there are some street dogs are there. It will harm our dog. So that is why I try to forbid the following of the dog. But the dog did not accept my word, and it followed even me. It lead me. It goes in front of me as if it is the leader for me. But when I reached when I enter into the first street, itself, it was surrounded by many dogs. Some ferocious dogs surrounded my dog. Now, what will be the psychological structure of my dog? What will be the psychological feeling? What will be the psychological emotion of my dog? Naturally, fear alone will be there. It will be afraid. It must have been afraid of the other dogs. So what, but I have no work, I have no power to safeguard my dog from the other dogs. They are numerous. My dog is single and the other dogs are numerous, 7 or 8. But some strange thing happened. What did my dog has done is that it has executed a different kind of strategy. For example, if you are living abroad or in another country for 10 years, and after 10 years you return to your own land, and where in a function you met many of your friends, what will you do when you met your friends after a long time? You naturally, you will ask the goodness of other people, how are you, in such a way you will ask other people of your friends. So in this way, our dog is also raising a friendly noise and we'll take a round within the other dogs. How are you? In this way, it gets a strange and friendly noise. But the ferocious dogs want to bite the dog, it confused. when they are trying to attack our dog, but this dog is raising a friendly noise. So they are rather confused. When they are in a confused stage, it take a round here and there, raising a friendly noise. And by taking a round there, it find a gap between the other dogs. And during the gap, it escaped from the place. Just run away and escaped without getting a single bite. So here, naturally, when you face the situation, the natural response may be fear. Whenever we are using the fear, what he has to do when we are having fear, we have to try to escape. If the dog try to escape with the help of the fear, naturally the other dog will sprang upon them. But when it understand the fear is not useful. So when the fear is not useful, it does not take the fear in its hand. When you do reject the happening of the psychological structure, new energy comes from you. When in the psychological structure itself, new energy comes from you. Even an animal has the capacity to deal with the situation in a different manner. So we are more powerful than an animal. So we have more capacity than an animal. So we have every capacity, the situation is important. We have to get our importance, we have to focus our attention only the situation. We have to exhibit ourselves to the object, not to the subject. But we have to put down the subject, put down the psychological structure, we have to take the object alone, situation alone in the hand. We have to, we may able to deal with the situation in a different perspective, different aspect, in a different manner. Such capacity will come automatically from ourselves. Because everything is related. Our psychological structure is related to the external thing. So sufficient thing, sufficient response will come from our mind itself. One person who has gone through many of my work and everything, one time he phoned me. I have read many of your books, I have seen of your videos and other things, I got freed from myself. I am all right. I think I understand that I have understood everything well. But today I got a problem. Previously I am all right. Now I am out from, I am not all right. Because I have to attend a meeting. It is 50 kilometers away from here. I am waiting for the bus for 1.5 hours. No bus is coming. The time is very close. Even the bus has come now, I cannot go to the function in time. So I feel very tension. So is it good for myself to get the tension even after understanding your teaching? He asked me question, how can get the tension like this? Should not be a calm in this period, in the time, even in the situation is worse. Should I not be a calm within myself? Why I have felt tension? He asked me. Here the position is that our concern must be only towards the external things. If we want to go to the, if it is very necessary, immediately necessary to attend the meeting, we may select other choice. There are many ways for to reach the office, reach the meeting place. There we may take any vehicle for that. We may choose another choice. But at the same time, when we try to get away from the psychological structure, I should not be tension. I should not have any tension. I must have peace of mind within myself. That means our concern is where we are focusing our attention to the psychological world. So our attention must be towards the external thing. Our attention should not be towards the psychological world. Psychological world, anything may come. Some good thing may come, bad thing may come, whatever may be. According to, as a reflection of the situation, some emotion may come. For example, if no bus is coming, instead of tension, if you feel happy, what will done? You will dismiss the meeting and you will go to the house. So actually the tension alone is a good thing. It is a good sign to give some inducement to attend the meeting. So you can make use of the tension. But at this, instead of making use of the tension to as an inducement to attend the meeting, if you get away from the tension, that means we want to have a good emotion within yourself. So you should not focus your attention toward the psychological world. We have to accept whatever comes, we have to take it as a natural thing. We have no right to question our psychological response, psychological emotion. It is natural. Whoever be in your position, the same thing will happen. So it is a good sign, it is a good symptom as an inducement to get to the meeting on time. So you can make use of that. But we have no right to question our psychological world, psychological emotion. It is a natural response. We have to accept it wholeheartedly. Because we have no work to set right our psychological structure in order. We think it is a disorder, having tension like this, we think it is a disorder one. But it is the order of the mind. It is the natural process of the mind. If it is necessary, you can make use of that. If it is not necessary, if you feel it is unnecessary, you need not worry about that. You need not face that. If you accept it wholeheartedly and train your mind to what you want, on that line, then the external situation alone, the necessary emotion will come from yourself itself. As in the case of the dog. For in the case of the dog itself, another fear has come. But it is not useful. When it is not useful, it does not work to set right the fear. So in this way, we have no work to set right our tension. If you do not take the work, if you take the emotion on our hand, it will be set right on its own. It will set right on itself. We need not correct itself. So psychological world alone is concerned, we have no work. For example, we are sitting in our room. So the calling bell is ringing. We have to open the door and inquire who is coming there. But if the calling bell is ringing on the next door, next house, is there any duty for ourselves to open the door and who are you to ask who are you? So whatever is going on in your psychological world is only the calling bell of the next house. It is not your house. So we have no right to answer it. We have to accept it as it a natural one. But the external world is not like that. External world is your world. Is it your house, own house? You are responsible for your own work. You are responsible for your own house. Where you have to attend your work. So the physical world is concerned. We have some work. We must have some planning. But in the psychological world, we must have some understanding. The understanding says that we have no work there. We have to take it as a natural one. If it is necessary for the external world, we can make use of that. If it is not necessary for the external world, we need not worry about that. Once a person, he was a student in a Christian missionary where he going to be a pastor of the Christian missionary. Some training was going on. And every day he has to give some sermon. He has to talk something on the platform. Because in future also he had to make sermon every day to the person coming for the worship of in the church. They have to give sermon. So he was taking training for that. But whenever he take the mic in the hand, he became trembling. He tried to control the trembling, but it is increases and it will not decrease. He is unable to get away from the trembling. But he simply, somewhere or other, he watched some of my videos clippings. And unconsciously, he got freedom from the problem. The trembling has gone away. Because the response, the reaction, we need not worry about the reaction. The reaction may be like this. We have nothing to do with the reaction. What our concern must be to the actionary world. What we have to do in the situation, that we have to do. This is what all those things are, reaction, psychologically reaction. For that, we have to accept it as natural. So when we accept ourselves naturally, some different kind of energy will take care of you. And everything will be all right on its own. You need not saturate yourself manually and consciously. It will happen, it will be saturated, it will be all right unconsciously. You need not worry about that. So the psychological world is concerned, we have to understand we have no work there. This does not mean that we have no work in the external world. So the external work alone we have to take in the hand, and we have to put down the psychological world totally. And now we can have some conversation, and we may have any question and answer. Here you can question related to the understanding or enlightenment, or with related to the, but you are not eligible to ask question because you are not attended the first, even though it is not good. So you have to be a silent watcher. So psychological energy is concerned, we have to understand. We understand we have no work there. So if you want to establish some energy, establish some pattern within yourself, you have some work. But if you have the understanding that we have some work there, psychological work, that means that is the waste of energy. For 1 or 2 years you may work to establish some energy field within yourself. As a beginner, you can have some work. But after if you go upon afterwards, the LKG and UKG, why should we go?
I keep on meditating. Even after you're selling, there is no work. Even the cycle, you fed up for a long time. Mm. Even after you stop, it goes on by itself. The same thing is happening in my case. I'm still meditating. Not because I want to meditate.
So if it is unconscious, it is a habit, it doesn't matter. But don't have any idea upon that. If you having idea means you are consciously giving some weight to that. So first of all, you remove the conscious weight upon those things. Unconsciously you may go along with that. But anything, some practices will give you some health process. Some health process, it you can continue. Some yoga process, some yogasana or anything, some breathing exercise, it will give you some health. In health aspect, you can continue. But in the psychological aspect, you need not worry about that. You have to simply leave that. You have no work there. As a beginner, you can do, but if you are not a beginner, you simply forget that.
I still have a habit of putting Padmasana, they feel good.
But if
you... So physical is fine, right?
Okay.
Whenever this psychological problem is there, so we do not give importance to it, or we do not associate with it, because we say that we have no rule. We will not control it. We allow it to flow by itself. So is it only when there is an issue you are facing that is creating a problem, and then this understanding helps you to come out of it, or in the natural state when there is no tension or nothing? What is the understanding?
So generally you have to sit down. Generally you have to understand psychological emotion, we have to take it as a natural one. Whoever in that position, this alone will be the result, this alone will be the emotion. So you are in that position, the emotion comes like that as a natural course. So there is no worry for that, a natural course. It will be like that. We have to accept it is a natural one. You have no work. So if it is unnatural, if you feel it is unnatural, then only you have to do something to make it natural. But it is natural, whatever. So whoever, for example, whenever you go in the dark and you see a snake, look at the snake, naturally some fear comes. It is a natural process. We should not try to be without any fear. It is a natural process. If you accept the response, accept the reaction as a natural one, you need not try to correct it. For that, the cycle of all psychological emotions is a natural one.
Just like the negative emotions, even if the happy emotions come.
Everything will come. Everything is come. But at the same time,
natural
one. So as we have rejected the negative emotion, we should not accept in the same way, we should not try to keep the good emotion forever. So whatever, we have to be in the natural process. Just like leaving everything on its own, we have to leave the good emotions also, happy emotions also in the natural process, coming and going. But you have to understand. If you understand, you need not tell yourself to allow it. It will be automatic process. Automatically, you will allow it to go. But you have to understand. If you want to establish your mind in a good way, and it does not have any bad thing like that, then only you want to regulate your mind. So you have to understand. You need not regulate your mind.
Third eye meditation for a long time. I used to see the image of Shiva. I want to open my third eye. That was my psychological desire to open my third eye. So 20 years I have meditated on this position. Even now I am having that pull here. Although I know that psychologically I had some fancy idea of opening third eye, but the energy is still here. Even after you are saying that I should let go, that energy, is this psychological energy or physical energy? What it is that 20 years of my meditation has landed me into, or what should I do with this? Should I allow this to go as it is?
So we should not give any importance to that. So you have to stop the giving importance alone. That is enough.
So that energy point, let it remain as it is, or go away?
Go away. But it will be all right on its. It will be all right on its own. You need not give any importance to that.
நம்ம சமூக மனம்னு எடுத்துக்கலாமா? நம்ம மனம்ங்கிறது பேசிட்டு இருக்கிறோம் இல்ல, அது சமூக மனம்னு நீங்க குறிப்பிடறதா எடுத்துக்கலாமா? When we live in the society, that அந்த சமூகத்தில் வாழ்றதுனால உருவாகிற மனம் அப்படின்னு.
So anyway, we have formed our mind, that was our memory. That means our memory. With the help of our memory alone, we are functioning. The memory may be the society may be the cause for our memory. It doesn't matter. So the memory we can have, the mind we are having, shall we take the mind as the mind given by the society? So here, whatever it be, everything we are doing only with the help of our memory. The memory may be the society may be the reason for our memory, but not only the society, our contribution, both are intermingled. Our contribution and the contribution of the society, everything intermingled. then only we are having the memory. And the memory may be the cause for our mind.
So at times you mentioned like at psychological level we have to accept our emotions. Other times you mentioned like we have to reject our emotions. So whether to accept or reject.
So that means accept and reject means in the same way. So accepting and rejecting means rejecting the total way behind, as we are rejecting the mind as we have no work. Accepting the mind means let it have a function on its own. That the both are the same meaning. Accepting and rejecting the same meaning. Accepting means we allow the mind function on its own. Rejecting means I don't have any work, so you function on its own. We reject our function. We reject our function on the part of the mind, and that means we allow the mind to function on its own. Accepting means also the same, accepting the mind to function on its own. The main thing is that the mind has to function on its own.
As a professional, I'm a writer. So most of the professions are mental in only.
Okay.
It is law or software or even writing. In fact, my profession is more mental because we only use the mind to write. We study others' mind. As a writer, I observe my mind very closely as well as others' mind so that I can write. So I am using my mind all the time for my profession.
Mm.
So here, where is the question of allowing the thoughts to go by? Many times we manipulate the thoughts. For example, I want to write on something. I manipulate my mind so that I can write for 1 hour or so many pages. So the chief concept here, if at all there is a concept, is to allow the mind to let go. But here in my profession, I have to use my mind. I have to control it. So where does this lead to in my case?
So here, your work is external. For the external, you have to use your mind. So you have to think. So then only you can work.
Mm.
So here it is not allowed. So unnecessary, the emotion natural comes naturally. You should not question the unnecessary emotions. Sometimes unnecessarily we may have fear, sorrow, or anything it may come. You need not worry about that. You need not to struggle with that. But this is a work. This is a work. For that, you have to put down your mind. You have to put the mind on the work. So that is natural. That is correct. You have to think. Then only you are able to write. So if unconsciously some ideas comes, then only I will make the unconscious idea into writing. So you yourself has to engage yourself in thinking. Then only you can write something. You can think something. You can find out some new thing alone. So everything. So it is an external work. For the external work, you have to do something. You have to do totally.
For the tension and all, we have to let go. Real thing we can continue
This is a work. We have to consider as a external work.
Do we neglect the psychological mind for taking any decisions if there is any controversy between the physical and the psychological mind?
So, please sit down. And if you have any emotion, for example, whenever you take some decision in the external world, but at the same time, you should not take any decision to saturate your mind. Saturate your mind means I must be happy always. I should not have any tension in my mind. I should not have any anger, fear. So if you try to saturate your mind in a good condition, good position, that is working towards you. But at the same time, whenever you are facing some situation, the situation may be some worse condition, and you have some naturally you will have some emotion like this. And here you should not have any good mind without any adverse emotion. But at the same time, the adverse emotion may be useful to deal with the situation. For example, you may have some anger. The anger may be useful to deal with the situation. For example, you are sitting in the house. Some lunatic person enter into your house. So immediately you got some anger. And with the help of the anger alone, you can drive away the lunatic person from the house. But in the same way, when the lunatic person enter into the house, and instead of anger, you afraid of the lunatic person. So you got fear. So if you have fear, you cannot drive away the lunatic person. So what will you do? You will go away, you will come away from the house and seek the help of the neighbors. So all come and drive away the lunatic person. So when the situation like the happens like this, no anger comes, no fear comes, what will you do? You cannot deal with the situation. So actually all the emotion comes for the help of the, to deal with the situation. Here anger helps you, fear helps you. But if no fear, no anger, then you cannot deal with the lunatic person. So you, if it is necessary, you can make use of the emotions. So confusion means different thing. So here, emotion straight away some emotion comes. If the emotion is helpful to deal with the situation, you can make use of the emotion. So your confusion is a different thing. Confusion means you must have some clarity. So then only you can act. And I'll take another time. What is the mind, intellect, and emotion, and ego? Some classification. Manam, buddhi, siddham, ahankar. Some classification is there with related to the function of the mind. So it's a different topic. And in that topic, we can deal with that, with what we have to do with the confusion. Most probably, after the break, we can have the thing.
So, what if I wrecked, as you say, with this lunatic and drive him away? I get anger and I drive him away. But if I watch myself, let's say for 1 month back, I can see I very often get angry and act out this anger, driving away things and creating problem for myself. So I can start to suspect the way I'm getting anger is not so good always. It's a little bit, you say it's always natural, but what if it's not in balance and you have to question why did I get angry in this situation? Maybe it was better not to be angry. And I have to, you say there is no psychological work. So in this situation, it seems to me there could be some work. So can you clarify this?
So sometimes the anger may be good to deal with the situation. Sometimes the anger may not be good, but anyhow we may get anger. So in that situation, what we have to do? So here, even though our concern must not be towards the anger, so we need not try to saturate the anger. So anger is natural, but at the same time, if the situation is good to make use of the anger or not, that alone is the important thing. So our concern must be towards the external world. In the external world, sometimes in the situation the anger may be good, sometimes the anger may not be good. So if you, for example, you are working in an office and under yourself some subordinates are working and they have done a wrong, and you have some anger and you can use the anger word to correct themselves, but there is no problem by expressing the anger. But at the same time, you have your boss and you are working under the boss, and the boss has committed a mistake and you got anger. Do you have any responsibility to correct the boss? You may correct, but at the same time, you cannot use the anger to correct your boss. So here, when your concern is to the external world, you can measure what kind of thing you have to do. If the anger is a good thing to use upon the boss, then you will use the anger. But at this, but there, but you understand, anger is not good to use upon the subordinate. It is good. It may not reflect. But if you use the anger upon your boss, you have to quit away from your job itself. You have to go away from the job itself. So when you understand the position of the situation, then naturally the anger will not be. It will be subside. It will be in a moderate condition. So you will have a moderate, so politely you can ask, you can point out the mistake of the boss, but at the same time in an angry manner. But at the same time you can correct the boss in a polite way. So here, there, whenever you face the situation, when you are focused your attention upon the situation will correct your sensation, correct your emotions. But if the situation requires the anger, then the anger will be comes out as it is. Otherwise, it will not come out as it is.
Okay, now, so if I understand this, this means also that I have no work psychologically, but I do have to be in control. So if anger arises in me, I will let this happen, but I will. Should be in control, so I will not let this anger control my behavior. There are two levels, it seems.
So here, when there is no there is no necessity to express your anger, but at the same time, anger is coming. Whether the anger will disturb your character, disturb your psychological structure, it may disturb. But at the same time, if you accept the anger wholeheartedly is the natural process, then the affected thing will be very less. Then it will affect very less because everything is flowing very easily. It will easily flow from yourself. For example, some fire is burning. If you put your hand in the burning fire, what will happen? The hand will burn away. But at the same time, the fire is burning. When you cross the finger, cross the hand like this, even though you cross the hand within the fire, it will not affect you. So in this way, whatever forces you, it will not take root within yourself. It will not take root within your character. It will pass through you, but at the same time, some less happening alone will happen. It will not punch you very strongly.
I have a similar situation about anger.
Mm.
I will give you the situation first. So my father, I'm very attached with my father. And whenever I go, I take my father to the hospital, I drive and he sits with me and he will do a lot of backseat driving. He will tell me, I'm going on the wrong road, I'm not driving well. And so I feel a lot of anger and I'm also very attached and I can't get angry with him and I get very confused and I make more mistakes on the road. So I come back, I'm like really tired after going to the hospital. I mean, it's very stressful. Even in the hospital, he will not listen. I will tell him to come this way. So he says, you don't know anything. And so there's a lot of emotions that happen at the same time. And I have to keep a control outside because there are doctors and there's a situation. So I feel very defeated and punctured at the end of it.
So here, your complaint is that your father is torturing you, not do this, not to do this. So thereby you are caught, you are affected and you want to respond, but as a politeness, you did not respond.
Sometimes I do also.
So, but here, when you keep the anger within yourself, and it creates some pain within yourself, even though you are not expressing it, it creates some pain within yourself. But you allow it wholeheartedly. That means you are not allowing it wholeheartedly. You allowing the anger wholeheartedly, then it will not give you pain.
So
actually right now, even talking about it has made me full, like I feel this heat all over my body, mm-hmm. just talking about it.
Mm.
So at that moment when I'm driving, mm. I should actually just observe it,
mm.
that there is anger.
Here you need not observe it. Observing means
but
you
it
want
comes
to
out very quickly.
But you the observing means unconsciously you may observe like this.
Right.
Doesn't matter. But don't try to consciously observe anger,
yeah.
or observe any feeling. Because
so
then that means you want to change the thing.
Yeah.
Change the emotion. Then only you observe.
Yeah.
So there is no necessity to change anything. You accept it as a natural one.
Okay.
So it is natural for yourself and to accept yourself. Here our concern must be towards the external world.
Right.
For the external world is concerned, what you have to do to your father, whether you have to correct your father, the father wants to correct you and you wants to correct your father. So here you have no work to correct your father. That means sometimes he may be very aged. So in that time he may not have the normal sense. So you need not worry about the functioning behavior of your father. You will be like that, as an aged person, you will be like that. We have to cope with him. You have to come to a decision like that, and you have to endure with him. So that is the thing.
So when the situation happens like this, I just let, like, what do I do? I really don't know how to think ahead, actually.
So here, we should not find fault with ourselves.
Right.
So whatever may be the emotion, it is natural. We have to we should not find fault with ourselves. All emotions are good and real. It is natural. So we need not find fault with that. Whether it is useful to the external world or not alone is the question.
Okay.
Whether it has to come to me or not is not the question. It has coming already,
mm.
and whatever comes, it is natural.
Okay.
We should not find fault with any emotion of ourselves. It is natural.
Okay.
We have to give good name to our emotion. It is natural.
But to accept our emotions, also we have to observe it first.
So naturally, unconsciously, you will observe, but you need not steadily observe it. You can notice it. It has come. That is enough. Even very recognition that some emotion you have come, some recognition itself is enough. You need not steadily watch your emotion. Watching is something different, recognizing is something different. You recognize something, anger, you recognize you have some anger, you have some fear, sorrow, you can recognize. But you need not watch means you are carefully watching the functioning of the emotion, that you need not watch.
Sometimes in the time of like we recognize it, we miss the bus. Like it has already acted. Like the emotions which ever came to our mind, it has already acted before we recognize it. So how do we recognize it at the moment, like when it has happened? Like,
so whenever you act unconsciously, it is unconscious action, but don't find fault with this. So if it is over, so don't feel guilty for any unconscious action. But at the same time, you take it as a guidance not to repeat the same thing again. So take it as a guidance. But at the same time, that you are not, that means as you have acted, that you are not justified. But at the same time, you should not feel guilty feeling as you have expressed anger, expressed some unnecessary thing. That means anyhow it has done and it is over. You have to feel, you have to finish with that. And you have to start the other thing afresh. And you need not worry about the past things. But anyhow, it may be wrong. But at the same time, you need not feel wrong. It has done anyhow. But we should not avoid the same thing again happen.
The emotion is there. But first of all, why does it come? Only after it comes, I'm recognizing. He's questioning why the emotion itself is coming.
I think he answered it.
Execution. Execution,
yeah,
of the emotion.
I can repeat the question. My question was like, you said we should recognize the emotion and then act accordingly. But many a times what happens is like the time we recognize that the emotion has happened, we have already acted on it.
But anyhow, but unconsciously, only after recognition, recognition is already happened. It has also happened unconsciously. You recognize, without recognition, you will not act. You recognize everything. Unconsciously, you will recognize yourself. You recognize your anger, recognize your fear, everything will happen. Everything is fraction of second, the recognition also will happen. It may happen unconsciously. Then only the reaction will happen. So
we have to do it consciously. Like we have to recognize it consciously.
Oh yeah, actions all conscious action, but anyhow, it may happen without your control. Some because sometimes it may be you may give some fast decision. With some fast decision alone, you can express your anger. But anyhow, it is a conscious anger. But within a fraction of a second, it may happen like this. Even then, you recognize like that. Some recognition is to be there.
So, if I understand you right, what you're saying is that I recognize the anger. Yes, everybody knows that that there is anger. So my action in the external world would be at that moment to just keep quiet. So my action in the external world is being quiet about it. Because I don't want to shout at my father. I want there is a lot of me which wants to respect him. And when I don't give that respect, I feel very low. I'm like, why can't I respect this gentleman? He's an old person. How much he's done. After the action is over, I feel like this. So my action in the external world would be to be very quiet. Is that right?
So here, so external world is concerned, everything is under your intellect.
Right.
So you have to make use of your intellect. Sometimes you might have done wrong. Sometimes you may have done good thing. So you have to evaluate. You have to evaluate and come to a decision. Sometimes you may change the way of behavior, everything.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
But all this strategy you should not apply to the psychological world.
Yes, yes.
Psychological world, we have to take it as a natural one. Whatever comes, it is natural.
Natural.
But in the emotional. Physical world, we can correct those things, correct the emotions, correct the actions. Yes. If you done a wrong thing, you have to change into a right one.
Yes.
If it is keeping quiet, then if it is find it is correct, then you can keep it correct.
Here the emotion has raised, so we have no corrective action to be done. We just accepted wholeheartedly. What he was saying is that before that recognition happens, or immediately after the recognition happens, reaction also has been done. So after the reaction is done, we recognize we got anger and we also acted. So it is an unconscious action and we should not be worrying about it.
So right? Whatever it be, whether the action is over, we have to put down everything. So what we have to do next alone is to take into account. If something, you may be wrong, your action may be wrong, but doesn't matter, you put down everything as it is finished.
Yes.
Then you have to take some lesson from that wrong action and you have to do the right thing. But the feeling guilty for the wrong action is not necessary. Then we make it as a psychological one.
I think you said you did not have the psychological mind, but as she said, for some people we know they will be very negative. When they talk to us, they keep on instructing us, which makes us feel irritated. So psychologically, before itself, we should be planned. They will be talking to us like this, so we should be in temper. If without that touching the psychological mind, if physically if we act, then there will be some fight. Right. How to deal?
So in the next,
only when we are mentally prepared previously, then we can handle easily. Actually, they will be talking like that. We should control our temper. It's natural. So we should be prepared psychologically before. No. Physically, if we act, definitely we will be fighting.
So after the break, we'll have a different kind of approach. Manam Buddhi Siddham Ahankar. There some answer may be there for your question.